Okay. Guys, we have Alain Ducasse here. Guys, we have fucking Alain Ducasse here. Yeah, all right. Alain Ducasse, I had posters of you in my bedroom. My friends, they had naked girls, I had a poster of you. He wasn't naked. All right. Being Alain Ducasse.
I've never seen chefs this nervous about meeting someone, which explains the ridiculous setup we have here. We have two chefs over here, this idiot, another chef to translate, a translator, and then Alain Ducasse. They're so afraid they put so much distance between themselves and Alain Ducasse.
Yeah, I'm going to be the first to go, so let's just say that.
So Alain Ducasse, besides being Alain Ducasse and having, you know, how many is it? 500 Michelin stars? I think there's few chefs here in the audience that hasn't thought of, what is it like being Alain Ducasse? You know the movie Being John Malkovich?
Dans la peau d'Alain Ducasse.
Do you know how many times I thought of that? Wow, what if they made a movie and it was called Being Alain Ducasse? So, I mean, we thought of, you know, how to do this. So we asked some questions in the audience, because I know there's many people who wants to meet him. And where do we start, chef? Francinelli? Who's gonna ask the first question? There's one there, up there.
Do you like sea urchins?
I like. J'aime. J'aime les oursins. Et j'aime les pêcheurs d'oursins.
And he loves the you know, the divers that dive for the sea urchins.
Do we have another question for Alain Ducasse? There's a question for Alain Ducasse. Shout it, Nicolas.
Okay, I've heard stories about Alain Ducasse. Like, he's like the Superman of the culinary world. And I have one story that someone delivered butter to your restaurant. And you tasted the butter, and you said, this must be cows that have been fed on wet crops.
Can you taste?
Hello.
Are you such a...
Tu sais.
Vas-y, tu traduis quand même.
Alain Ducasse, please tell us, do you have superpowers?
Tu comprends?
Tu connais l'histoire?
Non. Non.
Vas-y, vas-y.
Tu as dit. Il a dit
quelqu'un vient avec le beurre, oui. Et tu as dit, oh, c'est les vaches qui a mangé du...
I was at Dunbar restaurant a few years ago, yes.
At Dunbar.
At Dunbar, yes. I remember that.
So tell the story.
I'm not a specialist about the butter, but in this case, you can taste recognize...
Dites en français.
Ouais, j'ai expliqué à Dan ce que j'imaginais qu'avaient fait les vaches. C'est
he
très
tasted
important.
The butter, and then he told, it was Dan Barber, so he told Dan what he had imagined that the cows had eaten.
Parce que c'est important de savoir ce qu'ont fait les vaches.
Of course
sinon,
it's
le,
important.
Sinon le beurre, on ne peut pas bien comprendre. Et c'est comme c'est important de connaître le pêcheur d'oursin pour savoir ce que sont les oursins. C'est important de connaître les artisans qui sont derrière un produit, quel qu'il soit, de connaître l'animal qui est derrière un produit.
So he started having this whole conversation with Dan Barber about, you know, what the cows had been eaten, because Monsieur Ducasse, of course, thinks it's essential to know what the cows have eaten to be able to better understand, you know, the butter in this case. Same as the sea urchins, it's very important to know the divers, you know, to better understand what the produce will be like.
I need to ask you this, Ducasse. What is your darkest fear, Alain Ducasse?
What is
de quoi avez-vous peur le plus?
À titre personnel, j'ai peur d'avoir un jour à nouveau l'incapacité physique ou intellectuelle de m'assumer, d'être un individu actif dans la société.
Okay. On the personal on a personal level, I am afraid of having one more time the physical and or intellectual capacity to live by myself.
Et à titre professionnel, j'ai peur qu'il y ait une espèce animale ou une espèce végétale qui disparaisse sans qu'on ait le temps de la préserver pour que les enfants puissent la connaître et que...
Okay. And on a more professional level, my, you know, worst fear is that some species, whether they are animal or vegetal, disappear without we have the time to preserve or save them or know them, and without having our children get to know those species.
Okay. J'espère avoir assez de temps.
And I personally hope to have enough time. Enfin, he.
I once read that after a very specific incident when you were 27,
yes.
Alain Ducasse is the sole survivor of an airplane crash, that after that you lost fear. You were no longer afraid.
Alors, après l'accident de l'avion, c'est on dit que tu n'as pas peur. Peut-être pour les choses professionnelles, non. Pour prendre des risques.
La seule difficulté, il n'y a pas de problème dans la vie parce qu'il y a toujours des solutions.
There is no problem in life, what he learned.
Sauf quand c'est physique ou intellectuel.
That there is no real problem in life. The only real problem in life is that when it comes to your health and that when you have this physical or intellectual capacity to live by yourself. That's what he learned from the plane accident.
C'est la leçon que j'ai retenue de cette mauvaise aventure.
It was a bad adventure, that's what he learned about it.
Il y a toujours une solution.
There is always a solution. Ouais. There is always a solution. No. There is no problem, actually.
I saw some other hands for Ducasse. Oh.
René?
Yes. Where?
Diana Kennedy?
Diana Kennedy.
I just want to make a comment. I don't want to ask a question. That in the 1980s, I was in the Jursac. And I still remember the salade tiède des poissons that you served, and that wonderful meal, series of meals that we had. And that was, I don't remember, which was 1980 something. Okay. And I still thank you.
All right.
In Monaco.
Where was the other hands? Here. Let's do one here. A young student here. How old are you?
30 years, not too young.
3 years.
30.
Yes. Where are you from?
From Peru.
Peru.
Peru. What do you want to ask Alain Ducasse?
First, one thing, thank you for visiting Peru next week. Yeah! And the next one, what is the first dish do you prefer to eat when you get to Peru? Thank you.
Do you like a Peruvian dish?
Qu'est-ce que tu peux
just say no.
La cuisine péruvienne, quel est le plat que vous aimeriez manger? Le premier plat que vous aimeriez manger? Je vais
pour être perméable à tout ce que je vais essayer de comprendre le temps que je vais y être la semaine prochaine. Donc je suis curieux et perméable.
You know, it will be his first time in Peru, so he goes completely open-minded with full curiosity, and he will be, you know, open up to any, you know, any type of food and any type of, you know, different flavors that he will discover there.
Et des rencontres que je vais faire.
And of course,
et des individus que je vais rencontrer.
The people that he will meet there. He's very looking forward to that.
Ça va m'enrichir pour pouvoir, à mon tour, partager avec mes collaborateurs, avec les personnes que je vais rencontrer.
And that will be very important to him, these encounters and these meetings, to be able to share back with his collaborators and his teams when he comes back. That's what he likes to do as well, not to share, not to keep for himself, but, you know, share with his collaborators as well.
So, Renee, can I ask a question? Because we've all been talking about one thing in the back, and and by the way, me translating is probably the biggest and best joke you're going to hear all symposium. But we were talking about... Yes, thank you, Chef. Did I get the laugh or not? But we were talking about the Michelin stars and really this idea of ascending and how much is enough. Alors, nous avons discuté l'idée des étoiles et c'est combien c'est assez, qu'est-ce que c'est le chose qui te...
Les étoiles, c'est pas important.
Ouais.
L'important, c'est le plaisir que l'on a à partager sa connaissance au service des clients et au service des artisans, des éleveurs, des pêcheurs, de la nature qui nous ont offert de préparer au service du client. C'est ça le plus important. Les étoiles, c'est bien, on peut faire, c'est bien avec, on peut faire aussi sans les étoiles. L'important, c'est la relation que l'on a dans son métier et avec ses clients, avec ses fournisseurs.
You know, talking about stars, stars is not something in itself. It's good to have them, but we can live without. And, you know, to him, what is much more important is the relationship that you are developing years after years or time after time with your clients, but also with all your type of purveyors, your staff, your collaborators, and, you know, the fishermen, the foragers, and, you know, all the people that you have to live with, you live with pleasure in the restaurant. You know, that's this sharing. That is much more important, this relationship.
Yeah.
D'ailleurs, on ne court pas après les étoiles. Je cours après l'envie de rencontrer des hommes et des femmes qui vont me permettre de mieux comprendre localement là où je vais, avec une vision globale. C'est ça mon
He doesn't rapport. Run after stars. He runs after, you know, getting to know more, you know, the local environment wherever he has decided to settle a restaurant or whether he has decided to visit, you know, to better understand, you know, locally what's happening in terms of, you know, food and available produce and also, you know, the people living there and the environment. That's much more important for him.
C'est un très grand plaisir pour moi d'être invité ici et de vous rencontrer et d'échanger avec vous le peu de temps de la journée.
And being
c'est
invited
important.
Here, you know, by you and sharing with you and exchanging with you is a perfect example of what he is really, you know, super happy to do.
David
so thank you again.
Et René, merci pour cette belle initiative.
So David and René, thank you. Thank you so much.
I got a question. Well, chef, I think there's a lot of young cooks here, and I don't know if they know, but I'm a huge fan. I've always been a huge fan. You've always been this mythic like figure. And what was most interesting to me is that in your career, you've worked, when you're learning the craft, you worked for arguably the greatest French chefs as well, besides becoming your own, you know, style and creating so much for French gastronomy. You work for Roger Verger, Michel Girard, Alain Chappelle. When did you decide, now I have known and I know enough, I got I have to strike out on my own?
Quand est-ce que j'ai acquis suffisamment de connaissances pour décider d'être mon acteur?
Oui.
Très clairement, après Michel Guérard, Roger Verger, Alain Chappelle et Gaston Lenôtre, j'ai décidé d'avoir suffisamment d'outils, de connaissances culinaires pour partir tout seul et décider de faire des restaurants dont jamais le prochain ne sera le même que celui que j'ai fait avant. Mon idée, c'est de jamais faire le même restaurant. Donc, chaque fois, c'est de raconter une histoire différente. En fait, il faut raconter une histoire différente à chaque restaurant.
Well,
donc, il faut avoir une boîte à outils.
He decided that the time was right. After his experiences with, you know, Gérard, with Roger Verger, Alain Chappelle, and Gaston Lenôtre as well, you know, at some point he just say, okay, now is the time. And then he...
After Chappelle.
And then he decided that, you know, it was the right moment for him to settle, you know, restaurant by himself, that he had enough knowledge, and that it was the time that he had to go. So,
but how does he know?
23.
Comment
j'avais 23 ans.
Yeah, he was 23.
Mais comment savoir? Comment savoir à 23
that's
ans
que c'est
le parfait? Parce que vraiment, c'est pas l'âge, hein?
Non, non.
Comment sait-on?
C'est une décision.
Yeah, he decided. It's a decision, really. That's how he felt.
C'est la même décision.
There's no answer, Dave.
C'est la même décision que reprendre l'avion. C'est
well,
la même décision pour
you know,
moi
back to the plane crash you were talking about. I mean, it's
un
the same type of decision
yeah.
that boarding on the plane again. Like, you do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a question. You know, Dave spoke yesterday, and a large part of his talk about guts and being a restaurateur and a chef was about failure. And how failure can drive people forward and how you have to feed off of failure and take things all the way to failure. You're so incredibly successful. What part does failure play when you achieved so much? What motivates you to continue to be ambitious and to still have audacity and push things forward?
Comment vous rebondissez?
Ouais, est-ce que c'est nécessaire, important de faire des erreurs et pas justement des succès?
Et comment vous rebondissez?
Très clairement, on a décidé d'intégrer dans le développement de mes restaurants, d'avoir 10% d'accidents. Il faut 10% d'accidents. 10%.
When we develop the company today, we accept to have 10% of, we say, accidents. Things that just
si on a peur,
doesn't
si on a,
turn out to
si,
be.
Si on a peur, il ne faut pas entreprendre.
If you fear, if you think that everything is going to be 100%, or if you fear about this 10% or whatever percent, then you don't go enterprise and
you don't do it. Le développement, c'est des erreurs, en fait.
Oui, il faut des erreurs pour construire l'expertise.
Ouais. Failure
des erreurs,
is part of the success.
Tirer la leçon. Des erreurs, il faut.
If you learn from them, if you know how to learn from them.
Do you ever feel that there's still a possibility of 100% failure and not just 10%?
Est-ce que tu as peur de faire une erreur si grande, c'est
100%?
Non, ça peut arriver.
Oui.
Do you feel you have anything to lose?
Oui, ça peut arriver, mais c'est.
Est-ce qu'il y a?
Dans mes valeurs, dans les valeurs du groupe Alain Ducasse, il y a ne pas craindre et entreprendre, ne pas avoir peur et entreprendre.
I established some. You know, we talk. We have values in the company, 12 values and the core values, and one of these values is.
Ne pas avoir peur et entreprendre.
So
not have fear to take risk.
Exactly. Thank you.
What's that say again?
So to not be scared to take risk. So one of the most fundamental foundations of his company is to not be afraid to take risks. And even they have this 90-10 thing. So really 10% of the what they try should be a failure. Because otherwise they're not going to learn lessons and they're not going to develop. So it's actually built into the philosophy of the company that there should be 10% error or they're not learning enough.
D'ailleurs, maintenant qu'on a plus peur, on va pouvoir commencer à entreprendre.
Okay, ouais, and you know, now maybe we're going to be fearless, and then now will be the time to really, you know, start building the company.
What?
And developing.
Dukas, chef. I'm 35.
Good.
Chang is
36.
And there's a lot of young cooks here. What in your long career, everything that you've achieved, you've been the king, the emperor, you're the pope, and we're like priests. What shouldn't we care about? What at the end of a long career doesn't matter?
Qu'est-ce que c'est pour un cuisinier la chose le plus important? Alors, en fait,
c'est facile, c'est ouais. Tous les jours s'enrichir de quelque chose de nouveau. Aujourd'hui, je suis venu ici, je vais être demain plus riche de connaissances, de rencontres qu'hier. C'est en permanence essayer de rencontrer des hommes et des femmes, d'échanger pour s'enrichir, pour partager à nouveau. C'est ça, la quête permanente. De rencontrer des hommes et des femmes pour m'enrichir et pour repartager. C'est très clair.
Every day, so that every day brings him something that he didn't know. Like to learn a little bit more every day. You know, being here again is you know, a way for him to get from you all and all the chefs and the people being here is a way for him to get that.
La planète est riche de ses différences.
The planet is, you know, rich because of its differences.
Dans un monde global, il faut privilégier l'esprit local.
In a global world, what is important is the local spirit.
C'est cette diversité qui est la beauté de cette planète. Il faut le découvrir.
The diversity, you know, lies in. I mean, it's the diversity that stems from the beauty of the planet.
Yeah, and I would say thematically, all of the places being spread over the globe, but each one respecting the local traditions, the local cultures, and that's how they build out, is not a global brand, but a brand of association of local places.
Yes. Exactly.
Il faut à la fois une vision globale, une expression locale. Ouais. Il faut être local.
It's a global vision with local expressions, and he sums this up by saying local. Yeah.
Mm. What about fame?
La notoriété.
Is that important?
Est-ce que la notoriété est importante?
Non, c'est. Elle permet d'être sollicité, de voyager. Elle permet de. D'accéder à la découverte au bout du monde d'individus. J'espère que Atala, la prochaine fois que je vais aller au Brésil, va me faire découvrir des produits et des poissons que lui-même ne connaissait pas il y a 3 ans ou 4 ans. C'est ça qui me passionne.
Well, speaking about fame, I mean, in itself. Well, he didn't say much, but to him, it's an, you know, a way to give him access to the discovery of, you know, places, produce, like, you know, around the world that maybe he wouldn't have this access so easily without him being famous. And he's thinking about, you know, and maybe next trip to Brazil, and he hopes that, you know, with Alex Atala, you know, they will both discover some produce and some, you know, areas that maybe even not Alex knows. It's not in itself something that, it's not something in itself.
La notoriété, elle doit servir à passer un message, qui est le suivant.
And fame, you know, is a way to, you know, spread out a message, the following one.
Il faudra que le cuisinier il soit précautionneux des ressources rares de cette planète.
The cook really needs to be very, very careful about the resources that the planet has to offer. This is very important to him.
Il faudra très clairement manger moins de sel, moins de gras, moins de sucre.
We will need to eat less fat, less salt, less sugar.
Très clairement, les légumes, je fais un menu légumes depuis 25 ans à Monaco, très clairement,
vegetables,
les légumes,
very clearly,
les légumes, les céréales,
are, you know, part of, you know, what is going to be more and more important.
Sustainable fish, etc., etc.
He's been doing a vegetable menu at Louis XV, you know, since more than 25 years.
La notoriété, elle doit servir vous et moi à passer des messages importants pour la planète et les habitants de cette planète.
As a chef, okay.
Ça sert à ça la notoriété.
As a chef, really, fame is about spreading out the message, and that you know, all united, you know, we will be.
And responsibility.
In responsibility.
Yeah, exactly. the more fame, the more responsibility you have to use it in a way that helps protect the resources that we all use.
Et là, dans ce message, il n'y a pas de frontières, il n'y a pas de couleur de peau, il n'y a pas de religion, il n'y a pas d'ethnie, il n'y a rien. Il y a un message global qui doit être supérieur à tous les intérêts économiques, politiques, de race, de religion, les cuisiniers.
This message is really global and, you know, is beyond every differences, whether they are political or religious or, you know, any type of differences. It's really a global message that reunite all of us and that we need to all spread out.
One of the messages that I know as a young cook, I remember 1999, 2000, you decided to open up in New York, and that's all any cook or any chef could talk about, because you were like, oh my gosh, this legend, he's got 6 Michelin stars, he's coming to New York. We also heard the Michelin guide's coming to New York. It was this, you know, perfect storm of events. And how do you live up to those expectations? Because part of that message is, it's Alain Ducasse. You have Louis Kahn, you have Plaza Athénée. People have an expectation of getting the best meal of their life. How do you constantly live up to those expectations?
Alors, le pression d'expectation, qu'est-ce qui se passe avec votre...
C'est la partager. Ouais. La pression que j'ai, c'est la partager le plus généreusement possible avec tous mes collaborateurs.
He puts the pressure very generously onto his collaborators. Hello.
Can I just add? I can't speak for all of New York City, but I don't know. You gave everybody what they wanted. Everybody wanted decadence, they wanted luxury, they wanted quality that they had never seen before. And I'm still sort of trying to understand that meal that I had, and it really sort of fundamentally changed how I viewed food, because it just, I don't know, it was something I was like, maybe I can never aspire to do this. And in a very, very humbling way, it maybe pushed me in a way that I never thought I did. I'm just thinking about it right now. And I don't know, like, I would be so upset if I were you, because, like, you gave New York City everything that it wanted. It was what exactly wanted. Like, I don't know how, when you have your vision executed and it still isn't received, like, how do you feel about it? I would be so upset. I'm okay. Upset for
bon.
You.
Et moi aussi, j'agris avec David, parce que j'ai eu un déjeuner là, qui est 2001, qui était incroyable.
Ça dépend, la traduction, ça peut être arrogant ou incroyable.
Non.
Arrogant,
well,
non, je plaisante,
ah,
mais
ah, oui.
For the press was arrogant, ouais. Perception, for you, fantastic.
Oui, mais pour les cuisiniers, vraiment, c'était incroyable. Alors, qu'est-ce que tu as des émotions ou sur comment New York a regardé le restaurant? Bien sûr, il était pour un restaurant de luxe. Yes. Parfait.
Yes.
Vous n'avez pas été compris, en fait.
Oui, mais
comment vous avez...
L'important, c'est que je ne m'occupe pas beaucoup de savoir si le restaurant que je fais, il va plaire aux clients. Le restaurant, d'abord, la cuisine que je fais, il doit plaire à moi.
OK.
All right. I think we all understood that.
OK, yeah. You know, first, I you know, when I think about the restaurant, it's really, I'm thinking about myself. Like, is this restaurant I like it? I'm not really thinking about the clients at first.
Non, c'est, mais le cuisinier, il fait ça d'abord pour lui. Tous les cuisiniers ici, ils font la cuisine de leur cœur. Après, il y a les clients, et après, il y a la presse, et après, blablabla.
Chef is very selfish.
Un chef, il est très égoïste. Moi, je suis très égoïste. Qu'est-ce que je fais?
Chefs are very selfish, and when they think about restaurant, they do it first for themselves. D'abord, then they think about the clients.
I would say even a better way of putting it, like a positive way, is that just in a little lost in translation. But I think what he's saying is that it's important to have a strong idea and voice about what you want to do. And don't let anyone else say what it should be. Clearly. If first you yourself are happy, then you give it to your clients. And if it's the right fit, then fine. But if all you do is go to the clients and change, it's never a good restaurant. C'est comme ça.
L'important, c'est pas de faire la cuisine sous influence. L'important, c'est de faire une cuisine ou un restaurant d'influence. C'est pas sous l'influence.
One should not cook under influences. One should cook to influence.
To lead, not to follow.
To lead and not to follow, yeah.
And I feel like he influenced New York and we just didn't understand it. Like the critics didn't understand that it was all very positive.
Yeah. Et c'était une fabuleuse expérience. On a eu des très, on a eu 1500 articles de presse détestables.
We had like,
so what?
You know, 1,500.
Explain that.
Les journalistes ne sont pas obligés de reprendre ce que je viens de dire.
Well, we had 1,500 bad press, bad articles. Yeah. So what? You know.
Ça n'a pas changé ma carrière.
It didn't change his career. He didn't change the way he was.
Et ça n'a pas bougé
thinking his restaurant.
Et ça n'a pas bougé ma passion.
He didn't change his passion. He kept on. He kept on.
I mean, that's sorry to harp on because this is my only time I've ever had to like ask him these questions, but I sit on my chest forever because.
Can we just do this all night
long?
Yeah,
I know. Because I just feel you got robbed in New York, and I'm mad for you because I feel if you didn't open up, Thomas Keller would not be successful in New York City, and you paved the way for so much.
Clever.
But here, but listen.
C'est vrai. Non mais c'est. I think j'ai fait ce choix de prendre des risques. Et quand je suis allé à Paris, c'est la même histoire. Et quand je suis allé à Londres, c'est toujours la même histoire. Et là, je vais aller à Pékin. Ça va. Je pense que c'est.
He chose to risk it. It's really a choice. I mean, he knew he was doing things differently, but he chose to take the risk.
Mais à Londres, c'est pareil. À Londres.
In Paris, he did it too. In Monaco, at the time of the opening. In Monaco, so at the time of the opening.
All right, there's so many hands up. Alan, can you shout?
Est-ce que tu es obligé de faire quelque chose avec les autres chefs pour dire utilise pas le GMO?
Ben, mais il faut c'est une décision facile à adopter entre les chefs.
Ben, d'être un voix très
bien
fort
sûr, il faut
pour les chefs.
Il faut. C'est une décision facile à adopter.
Il
suffit de décider de nous. Autant que possible, jamais on va utiliser du GM dans l'ensemble.
Yeah, as far as we are concerned, I mean, as long as possible, we will not use genetically modified produce.
Mais le pouvoir, il est politique
it's
et économique.
You know, it's also in the hands of the economical and political power. But, you know, back to your question, you know, chefs could easily have this voice. Chefs together could easily have this voice.
Je pense que les chefs du monde peuvent avoir, encore une fois, un rôle important
yes,
pour
chefs.
Combattre les OGM. Oui.
In the world, yes, yes chefs can have yes. an important power yes. to fight yes. against genetically yes. modified produce. Yes. yes.
Et après, on peut parler de la nourriture des enfants.
But then after, we could also come to the topic of child ouais. food.
Chaque
nutrition, children nutrition, oui. you know.
On peut engager, je pense que la médiatisation des chefs permet d'engager plusieurs combats au-delà des frontières, au-delà de la politique.
Fame, back to this, fame could, you know, also be, you know, a way for chefs together, you know, to have a voice heard, you know, on different subjects and topics beyond, you know, their, you know, unique and, you know, cuisine, their own thing. Like together, they can have a voice on many subjects. This is one of them, but there are many others.
Yeah. All right. I have
in 1 minute.
1 minute. That, this is actually saying that we're 5 minutes over. We've already gone over. No. yes.
Chef Ducasse, it's a great honor.
Yeah. First of all, great gardener. Great gardener.
It's not easy. Huh?
First of all, I agree with David. Essex House was mind-blowing. You know, I flew all the way from California on a young cook's budget just to eat there, and it blew my mind. It's a meal that still resonates to this day, and I, for the life of me, cannot figure out why it's not still there. But anyway, I just wanted to say that a lot of young cooks, when we're all very, very passionate, we're young, and we're working hard, and we're learning, we usually have one meal in our life that kind of changes our whole perspective, and it resonates with us for the rest of our lives about the power of cooking and what it can do for clients and what it can do for us for our career. And my question for you is there a meal that happens sometime in your life, perhaps as a young cook, maybe in someone's home, maybe a colleague's house, that truly spoke to you, that resonated with you to this day, that you remember every taste and every bite, and you still use that as a motivation moving forward? Thank you.
C'est très simple. Quand j'étais jeune commis chez Michel Guérard.
He was working as a commis, young commis at Michel Guérard's in the southwest.
Très peu payé.
Like he had like nothing as a pay, you know, very few money.
He was broke.
Yeah, who could say that?
Et on a décidé d'aller dîner chez Alain Chapelle.
And they decided to go to a place, you know, 800 kilometers away from where he was working. It was called Alain Chapelle at the time. They decided to go and have dinner there.
Et après le dîner, j'ai décidé que je n'avais pas compris la perfection de ce que j'avais mangé.
And after the meal, he realized that he had not understood anything about what he had just eaten.
Et comme j'étais déjà engagé pour aller travailler chez Roger Verger, mon obsession, c'était après d'aller travailler chez Alain Chapelle. Et c'est ce que j'ai fait.
He was already hired to go and work with Roger Verger. So he went at Moulin de Mougins. But with one single idea in mind, go back to this place, Alain Chapelle, work for this chef and understand a little bit, or understand, yes. learn about what he had.
85%.
It was an obsession. Yeah. It became an obsession, and he did it. He made it. A couple of years ago? How long ago? After?
Three years after. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, in closing, Chef Ducasse,
merci,
is cooking better now than it was today?
Est-ce que vous cuisinez mieux? Oui.
Ouais.
Ah oui.
Tu cuisines mieux aujourd'hui? Est-ce que la cuisine, généralement, c'est mieux?
C'est fantastique. C'est le niveau culinaire partout dans le monde
ouais.
est extraordinaire. J'ai la chance de faire 4 à 6 fois le tour du monde par an. Et je suis toujours très ému partout dans le monde qu'il y a un individu, un cuisinier, une cuisinière, un éleveur, un ramasseur de champignons, un cultivateur. C'est l'histoire, non pas d'une entreprise globale, mais c'est toujours l'histoire d'un individu. Plus un individu, un cuisinier, un fournisseur, un vigneron. C'est toujours l'histoire des individus et non pas du monde global, non okay. pas de l'industrie.
I think it's a yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So he's So he's touring the world several times a year, and he's amazed to see the extraordinary increase in the quality of the cuisine worldwide. But beyond this globality, he always finds an extraordinary person in the place where he goes, whether it's a cook, but it could be also a forager. It's a question of extraordinary individuals that will have such a motivation and such an energy that they will, you know, make the world so extraordinary culinary-wise as it is today.
On peut dire que c'est le début d'une belle aventure culinaire.
It's the beginning of an extraordinary adventure culinary-wise.
Alain Ducasse, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.